after that. First half time. Thought matters, boys. You know, the emphasis of pounding and thought, I thought it sounded the tone for Arizona running this thing. And Julie Bernard, the only guy with a phone play after he killed him.
I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone on my own. Nobody better ask me for none. Remember, you was sliding in that
four. Oh, shit, when all games get played.
Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can. Go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own stuff, don't need a backup. I'm tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full of gold.
Ain't gonna be no force dubs and no force sims and no force dubs, man.
15 miles due west of the Atlantic, nestled in downtown Jacksonville at TIAA Bank Field. A few minutes prior to us coming on air, this crowd was jolted into action with the introduction of these Jaguars. They're set for football as the Jags are ready to match up with the Houston Texans. Fielded just outside the goal line.
I'm walking on the dark road, huh? Come on, huh? I'm on my own.
Inside the 20.
Who hooping? Okay. Let me put it on TNT.
So from inside the 20,
college basketball is boring if it ain't the March Madness. College basketball.
Forthcoming. And Charles, for this defense, you know, they're a confident bunch. Some may say maybe too confident at times. How do you think that they approach a game like this when they're taking on a team that's lost four straight?
Well, if they're anything like their head coach, you know they're relying on that confidence. You and I both were sort of surprised at his weekly press conference when he was asked about this being a trap game.
Oh, give me that pick.
He didn't see anything to worry
about.
He
catch that?
Surprised both of us in a big way. Because we know that could be a dangerous tactic, because I can guarantee you, the guys on the other side, they heard that, and they're looking for anything to galvanize them.
An early test, two plays in, this is third and two. Out of the gun, Watson. He's letting it fly for Cooks.
Oh, picked out. NFL dot.
Not the way you wanted to start this ball game.
Come on, Coach.
On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away.
Oh, get Luke, get run from.
A field flipper there, a 47-yard punt coupled with a loss on the return. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10.
Oh, I'm talking on the dark road.
Off the play fake, here's Lawrence. And in
oh, you got to get cut. You can't drop passes like that. Not for us. Come on.
So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise.
Yeah, I know.
Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say
he just tackled
right
me.
But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on.
Come on, y'all.
Right,
the nigga just tackled me.
He is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat in every meeting with reporters this week? He kind of said, I've had enough, and I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
Look at me, zipper!
On third down, Lawrence. And that's complete ETN out of the backfield.
Let's go, ETN.
And he takes us beyond the 30.
I'm gonna jag him with other lead.
Defensively, they came into the game with the understanding they'd have to slow him down on passes just like this because he was over 100 yards receiving a week ago. And you know they're going to get him a volunteer as well.
Throwing again here. It's Lawrence. That's caught. It's Dan Arnold, the tight end.
Not him.
Be taken down, but not
go ahead, you could do it for me.
The 50.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the
I'll
outside,
plus
make sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus, and indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Meanwhile, Lawrence's throw into the hands of the receiver, Chanel. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A big play there on the catch.
Don't worry about that. I'll take care of it.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup. Flushed out right. And this is caught at the 8.
What is it, holding?
He's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on
the field.
Got to
chill with this holding, man. Come on.
Taylor, the right tackle. They're backed up here with a first.
I might make the quarter 5 minutes. That's what I might do.
Running out of the gun with ETN.
You think so?
It's a gain of 7 on the ground. Second down coming up. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field of the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling, and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
That's going to be caught. It's Chanel. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate.
Oh, y'all niggas DM it, huh?
Field gained nice chunks of yardage, but now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that would be pinpoint here.
I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharp.
Oh, you need to be winning.
So far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off.
Oh, okay.
The bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
Once more, ETN. And he takes it in. Touchdown.
Direct message.
Travis Etienne.
Can message directly. If it ain't directed, it ain't respected, huh?
Okay. Alright. And it's now a 7-0 game.
That's cool.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. This will be fielded inside the 5. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20.
Offer Brian Flores $100K to paint the season. I'm
going
to tell y'all some crazy shit. The year that I got cut, and some athletes, I told athletes, hey, man, I feel like I'm getting sabotaged. That's just how I feel. There's no way that we should be running the same exact plays. I remember going to the coach there in office, asking, hey, man, you know, I look forward to the game plan. Why am I lining up in the same play each and every week? Like, if these guys...
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the game.
I know I'm 1-on-1. Back don't even look my way. So many times on field,
And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line. You know, if following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under, CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you actually have to do the opposite of what you would think. You know,
it evades the tackle and now some space. And he'll be down deep into Houston territory. It's a big play for the Jaguars.
So about
this for field position after the big play inside the 15 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Here's a give to ETN. And he'll be brought
right behind
the
motherfucker.
Keep in mind, they can still get a first down here as they come up on 2nd and inches. A handoff for ETN. No dice this
ain't no way.
Round. He's hit behind the line and taken down. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up 3rd down.
They said no.
Take this into the end zone.
I'm trying to hoop. You niggas ain't hooping later, man. Let's hoop tonight.
Travis Etienne. with his 19th touchdown, his second of the game.
I'm behind.
The Jaguars are off to a 13-0
first quarter. Finishing up another left down.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. Taking in at the three. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So, they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now, they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. From the gun, here's Watson. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. Josh Allen. It'll go as a loss of about eight as he gets in there to drop him. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Following the sack, it's now third and long for Watson and the Texans. Pressure coming, and they got him once again. Dwayne Smoot, he's the one to get him this time, and back-to-back sacks.
I'm
going to
get on the down, bro.
Goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Jags will have great field position to start this drive as they take over on the short side of the field. And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. On the slant, this is Chark. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. They'll come up now on second and a yard.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, the offense can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule.
I'm looking at the dog, bro.
Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. He's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for defender.
Right there, Shenault for the Jacksonville touchdown. LaVisca Shenault, his third touchdown now on the year.
Yep.
And the Jaguars add 6 to their lead. Extra point by good. And that makes the score 21-0.
That dude that was trying to get an invite to the league, I think his name is Cameron. And then, who's your thief?
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
I'll be on in about 20 minutes
to go here for their next and some dangerous territory. Already down 3 scores, a 3 and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Back to throw, Watson. Finding some room at midfield. And he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half,
should I be ready? If y'all run one, I'll be ready, yeah.
Something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
Come on, Midwest bum.
Opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be second down. These two teams, they met in Houston earlier in the season with the
Texans
coming
out on top.
So a win here in Jacksonville would give them the season series. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. That's caught out wide by Cooks. And some room to maneuver. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That catch, by the way, number 542 in his NFL career, that draws him level with Lance Allworth, who was a Hall of Famer with the Chargers back in the 60s and 70s.
Yeah, the man they call Bambi. So if you're in that type of territory, catch the same number of passes he caught, you know you're on your way to a big-time career. And just think, he's not through yet.
From the red zone now, Watson flush to his right. To the goal line, but it's
let's go, Jaguar. You're not playing no game.
Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
You're not playing no game.
Second and 10.
Get inward.
Throwing again is Watson.
Oh, he ran past the line. Okay, I see you, Deshaun. But that's illegal.
So let's see what this is about.
We're going to man up right here.
Maybe worse than the loss of yardage, they also lose the down. So now it's third and long. Now it's Watson. Eluding the pressure right. And he will not throw it away. He goes out of bounds.
What the fuck is that?
Ding, ding, ding,
ding. What the fuck is that?
Ding, ding, ding. Comes Texan kicker Kaimi Fairbairn for the field goal from the right hash. This from 45 yards away. The kick by Fairbairn is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
Takes it at the 7. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they, on paper, Charles, no doubt they have the edge in this one. They are sitting with the AFC elite, and on the other side, they're down toward the bottom of the AFC. But you know what they say, especially at this point in the season, watch out for a trap game.
And in doing so, I would take my game plan and condense it. I would rely on my fundamentals.
Yeah.
The players are probably just better, and not try and do too much. Do just enough to win the game. And on the other side of the field, I'm doing everything. Every trick play I can think of, every different formation, you name it, I'm throwing it at them in order to try and get the upset win.
The tackle made by Eric Murray. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he'll get it down to the plate of the 37.
And that's a pleasing run there by Travis Etienne. And every time I see him carry it, I think of the word mature. Why? 4 full seasons at Clemson, not something you normally get with a running back. Had almost 5,000 yards rushing, the school record, along with 70 rushing touchdowns. That's both the school record and ACC record. The second running back taken in the draft after Najee Harris from Alabama, number 25 overall. He's now wearing number 1 in the NFL after wearing number 9 at Clemson. He loves those single digits.
Brings up second and 4.
The last run got 6, now second and 4. And now they'll throw it with Lawrence. They'll try and set up the screen to ETN. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game, that's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back.
Come on, y'all got to get a block on that.
Up a first down.
Despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Travis Etienne with touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead here in this first half. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And the round is on here in this first half. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. On first down, Watson. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down. Here's second and 10. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
What?
So we hit the halftime break here in Jacksonville with the Jags on top.
About to.
We now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Final adjustments being made for the second half. Whether they'll amount
to 115?
It's already pretty well decided. Well, that's another question. Nevertheless, let's get you back out to Brandon and Charles.
115-50, don't play with me. Get your ass beat. Don't play no motherfucking game with me, man.
Okay, Coach, thanks.
Do not play with me like that, ho.
We in for more one-way traffic here in the second half. It has not been a competitive game to this point.
Let's get it, man.
The Jaguars in possession of the lead, and they will get the football as we are underway in the second half. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, man, let me load my gun up, man. Right.
And it's hard to imagine that the first half could have gone any better for them, so what's the approach here in the second half?
Just continue to play smart football because they get the other team down and they feel good about the position they're in.
Going through the third, I'll be ready in about 12 minutes, 13 minutes.
Avoid turnovers. That's about the only thing that can derail you at this point.
No, I didn't. Nigga. I said give me about 20, 25, man.
On second and very short, Lawrence is complete.
Let him know, Midwest bum.
And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
You know, yeah, you never were good at math.
I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you
but
still
I know how to count.
Zone, go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle.
Mm.
It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure
towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield. Man, fuck you.
2 yards on the pickup there.
I don't have to chew the clock. Every second down, I'm going to chew the clock. Forgive me, Lord.
And they'll go again.
What are we about to do to this minute, man?
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 64 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now here's a throw. It's complete. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you got a drag route on as your primary
Eagles.
Call,
I mean, Dolphins, Titans, Eagles, yeah.
About how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Vision and speed, two of the attributes that you might say are important for a free safety, and we saw both in evidence there.
So I'm raised by.
If they score on this drive, might have to start digging in for second-hand blowout material. And now Chenault on the end around. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. From the 27, Lawrence. That'll be caught right side, Chenault with it. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. Whatever the discussions were at halftime,
Thomas Freeman
has not worked to this point.
I should have kept it off. They got Waddle, 97 speed, but we want Detroit, man.
Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working.
And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Travis Etienne, his 21st touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
Extra point. Raised ball.
And that will extend this big lead.
I'm all night, man.
Kick it away.
Man, I'm hooping, shooting. Don't make me download there.
Just outside the goal line.
The goddamn, goddamn.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Now, after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side, because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over him.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
He's going to air it out for Dorsett. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in.
Pretty
symptomatic of how this game's been going.
The passing windows
are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And this will be down just on the other side of midfield.
Let's go.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
Now, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they?
When everything is working for them,
every move they make works, it clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. Play action. It's Lawrence. Pass pulled in by Jones. What a catch. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses.
Yeah, I need about 7 minutes.
Back to back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Appreciate it.
Shotgun snap and a give to ETN. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Jimmy Moreland there on the stop.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this
offense. I'm talking about myself.
I know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
On second down, what you mean? Once more. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
I know flashy plays,
this ain't going to work with me,
like to call them, that attracts a lot of attention. But let's face it, when you're efficient, That can control a ball game, and I love the game plan they've got going right now.
Back-to-back 5-yard
game. Nigga, I wouldn't be working with you no way, nigga. You'll be working for me.
Line, they're getting it done.
And that is going to do it.
Nigga, I'm the one to send you on a mission, nigga.
Watching the NFL on EA Sports.
My bad, a quest. I'll send you on the quest. Get you some money in your pocket. Get you a little bit of money now in your posture.
He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
The short field shrinks even more with the AFC West, yeah.
Kirby, Hank, Cameron, and Ryan Platt. Hell yeah, come get you a spot, man. Cameron something.
Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long third and goal.
I have to laugh a little bit because
Cameron something.
He actually handed it off. I thought with the two touchdown passes, he's thrown in this one already. Mm. Go ahead and fling and try and get a third one.
Yeah, now from this spot on third down, I think he'd probably throw it here. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Trevor Lawrence, an 8-yard touchdown run. And the Jaguars are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And the lead will swell by one more. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. It's now appearing that this losing streak is going to continue. You know, the coaching staff was Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it.
Oh, good move.
Grab it, and they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
On second down, Etienne once more. He will push his way down to about the 14. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
We talk about the
linebackers keeping their eyes in the right spot and their eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try.
Touchdown, Jaguars! LaVisca Chenault with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Jaguars are closing in on a ninth victory on the year as they extend their lead. Extra point by Badgley.
Oh, good.
And that will extend this big lead. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Hank Garrett.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big play that time on the catch and run. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Watson now to throw. And that nearly intercepted.
Oh, who's the Texans? I forgot who the Texans. Ricky Davis, the Texans.
Kurt. Point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can.
Who's
they're
what?
Still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Watson. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 24. And now off to the races down the right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
With who?
Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the group.
Who's the Jets? Oh, Beeman's Land. Beeman's Land is the Jets.
Very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season,
Dustin,
it's been a big year, let alone back-to-back weeks.
No, the Titans are in the AFC North, AFC South. Jet, AFC West, Chiefs, Chargers, Raiders, Chiefs.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And the lead was
Patriots, Jets, Dolphins, Bills. And the Titans is Jarvis Johnson.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case.
This is supposed to bend over, but this nigga want to act like he's playing.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack. Devon Hamilton. What an effort from him on that play. Big tackle for a loss of 11. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. To throw is Watson. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
2 minutes left, fellas.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way
no,
that
three,
this one
3 minutes, my bad. 3:43, man.
Which is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer
yeah.
in this one.
No, I got it. Oh, let's go.
Offensively lucky they're able to keep the football, but now fourth down, so they'll have to boot it away.
He sent me an invite.
They're going to look at this as a positive. One, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession.
I mean, Wolf like it.
Changes field position for them. Imagine if that not turnover too, takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
35 yards.
I mean, yeah,
that will come the offense as they take over.
I'm 2 o'clock. I'll be there in 5 minutes.
Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And this
if
crowd
go another club, I'm
seen their guys fully expected to win this one coming in, and they have not disappointed as they've got the big lead here in the fourth. They're going
to
snuff this one down
to
behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes. And boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display, and now they look to polish it off. 128 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
I mean, it's 2 minutes left. If I get this first down, I'm going to milk out the clock right now. You feel me?
Practice for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield. They had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
And the punt team on now as this one sent away. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon.
Where'd I say?
They've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the
end zone. Oh, you headed down there?
The top.
Throwing on third down, Watson. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that will be incomplete.
It's about to bounce out, beat Miami.
But it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. 36 yards on the punt with no return, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4 seconds.
And kick you out.
Well, these two teams, they met up way back in the season. And it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back
here. They're right here, they're right.
Second down, ETN once more. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Off the option, here's ETN. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. But Charles, it's one thing to win.